Hello, my friends. This morning, I would like to talk to you about the future of our Park Avenue Theater. You know, that wonderful organization which provides such meaningful entertainment for us and such a joyous means of artistic expression for our youth. While trying to wrestle with our response to the COVID crisis, your session has also been praying and working together to respond with hope and compassion to Kelsey's resignation in September as Director of Youth Ministries, and her proposal to take Park Avenue Theater with her into the community as an independent theatrical production company. Our challenge has been to find a way forward which fundamentally respects the major role that you, our Trinity family, has played in building and sustaining Park Avenue Theater as a critical component of our youth outreach ministry mission, while respecting the hopes of those who would like to continue this as an independent theatrical production company. That being said, the session is now leaning towards a compromise, which will give a little something to everyone. But we also believe we should not continue to have this discussion in a vacuum, and we owed it to you, the congregation, to let you have a voice. Accordingly, we will be scheduling an open session meeting in conjunction with a congregation town hall Zoom meeting for Tuesday evening, December 29th at 6:30. The purpose of this meeting is to allow you to hear what we believe to be the way forward and for you to be in a position to ask questions and respond to our counterproposal. Members of the congregation will receive an email containing the particulars of how to join this town hall Zoom meeting. Thank you, and may God bless you.
Welcome. Welcome to worship here at Trinity Presbyterian Church. We are so glad that you are here with us. No matter who you are or where you are from or on your life's journey, you are welcome here. Today we have a very special musical service of Advent ready for you, presented by Linda Hoover and Ryan Gaston-Way, sharing their amazing and beautiful voices with us. We have Jennifer Harvey not only sharing her amazing voice, but also the beautiful sound which she pulls from the keyboard which she plays. And we have Joni Allen and Bill Wolf, who also bring to us their beautiful sound born from the strumming of the guitar and from their incredible voices. And operating the sound for us today, we have Spike Foley, a master talent on the soundboard, helping to bring all of this together for your listening pleasure. Thank you all for this wonderful opportunity to be here and offering this gift of worship to our Lord and God. Let us worship. We celebrate the seasons of the year, the seasons of our hearts, and the seasons of our lives. Each Advent season is a gift given to enrich us 100-fold. The time is now, the place is here, and so we begin our pilgrimage. God owns this planet and all its riches. The earth and every creature belong to God. God set the land on top of the seas and anchored it in the deep. Who is fit to climb God's mountain and stand in that holy place? Whoever has integrity, not chasing shadows, not living lies, God will bless them. Their Savior will bring justice. These people long to see the Lord. They seek the face of Jacob's God. Stretch toward heaven, you gates. Open wide, let the glorious sovereign enter. Who is this splendid ruler, the Lord of power and might, the conqueror of chaos? Stretch toward the heaven, you gates. Open wide, let the glorious sovereign enter. Who is this splendid ruler, the Lord of heaven's might? This splendid ruler is God.
Our first song is called Let the Valleys Be Raised. It's based on Isaiah and Luke 2:3.
Thank you.
The light without the darkness, and many blessings come from the darkness and silence that we experience when our souls are really touched by the presence of God in us. This next song is called Holy Darkness. It's inspired by John of the Cross.
Silence.
Christ in Advent, but it just gives you a little taste of the birth of Jesus. Ready?
Over unto us, baby child is born, baby son is given. Come, Holy Spirit, come, Father, this child. Virgin Mary shall be his mother, and his name shall be
untouched by life, holy, blessed among all people. And God cared for her with a loving hand. The Eternal One protected her with a loving hand. The Eternal One protected her from harm's way, preparing her for a holy birth. Emmanuel, God with us. A human vessel held the living word. Incarnation. God with us. Vulnerable, young, she said yes. She risked for her God and for the whole of creation. She and Joseph traveled in darkness, trusting the mystery.
Thank you.
guess by now that's a version of the Magnificat, because this section is devoted to Mary. We're going to do a different version of the Magnificat, written by a fellow named David Kaufman from down in Texas. And this is called Behold.
Behold, the mighty one has done great things for us.
Now we go to the personal experience of Mary. And if you can just imagine, really a young girl, probably in her teens, having been told that she's going to be the mother of God, and then traveling with her husband through the night to the town of Bethlehem, and what she might feel inside as she ponders the wonders.
Thank you.
know, with these masks on, almost we could use a breath of heaven.
But not send anyone to heaven too soon.
Not too soon. So we've practiced for quite a while to learn this stuff. And I have to tell you, there's a lot of joy in practicing. Amen. So we got to know each other more deeply. And every time we practice, every time we sing, you know, if you sing, you pray twice at the same time. So this next song, I'm sure you'll recognize, it's called Mary Did You Know? Was written by Buddy Green, but of course is made famous by a man and a woman. I'll let you guess who that is.
Come, Lord Jesus, day spring of our lives. Brighten our hearts with your love. Lead us through darkness to a new day filled with your light. Give us, O God, the vision that can see your love in the world, in spite of human failure. Give us the faith, the trust, and the goodness in spite of our ignorance and weakness. Give us the knowledge that we may continue to pray with understanding hearts. Show each of us what we can do to further the coming of universal peace in our broken world. Father of heaven and earth, the day draws near when the glory of your Son will make radiant the night of the waiting world. May the simple beauty of Jesus' birth summon us always to love what is most deeply human and see your word made flesh, reflected in those whose lives we touch. May the lure of greed not impede us from the joy which moves the hearts of those who seek him. May the darkness not blind us to the vision of wisdom which fills the minds of those who find him. Our glory will be to stand before the world as your own sons and daughters.
Next song is one that's full of energy. That's because when we anticipate the coming birth of Jesus in our hearts, we have to rise and feel the sheer grace that he bestows on us only if we're there to receive it. This song is called Rise, O Jerusalem.
Thank you.
A servant is come to live among the generation to one. In the splendor of faith and beauty, Jesus the Lord.
The end of things. The next song is called Sing Out, Earth and Skies. We have fun with this because there's kind of a male and female part to it. Hopefully we'll get it right.
There's a chance.
Encompasses in one song really the whole gist of what Advent really is. Okay.
Can you believe in a miracle coming? Can you believe it will take you away? There will be living where once there was death. There will be new life in Jesus.
Can you believe this charity coming? The only Lord now that comes to a way. There will be living where once there was death. And will be living in Jesus.
Can you believe that being over?
Parts of two songs, Surely the Presence of the Lord by Lanny Wolfe, and O Lord, You're Beautiful by Keith Green. This concludes our concert for today. Thanks to all of you who have listened and viewed online in your homes. Again, special thanks to Spike for doing our sound, Sue Marie for our readings. Finally, I want to thank this group for their many weeks of heartfelt practice. Ryan, Linda, Joni, my daughter Jenny, and even myself. So be safe, and above all, be grateful for the wonderful gift of Jesus.
During this time of darkness. So thank you so very, very much, each and every one. And so yes, know in your hearts, know in full belief of body, soul, mind, and heart that Christ does and will enter into the darkest of hours. God is with you. Emmanuel. Amen.